He's belted by Lindros. He scores!
He was a childhood prodigy. I remember growing up in Toronto and hearing a lot about Eric Lindros.
Everyone had the expectation that he was going to be the next great one.
The Quebec Nordiques are very proud to select as first pick overall in the 1991 NHL draft, Eric Lindros.
The big question now, of course, though, is will he sign with the Quebec Nordiques?
Quebec held his rights for one full year, then, still unable to sign him, dealt Lindros to Philadelphia in a blockbuster trade.
We wouldn't be giving up as much as we have if we didn't feel that Eric Lindros was worth a substantial contract.
We didn't see guys that size with that talent.
He was that new physical power forward that happened to have really good hands.
Eric was one of the only guys, 6'4 and bigger, that can move and do the things that he did.
It's a much more physical game than it is today. And that's what you have to do to get through and get to the puck, get on the forecheck. Everything went big.
Lindros moves in, score!
He was a horse. I'm not sure there's ever been a player quite like Eric.
He'd run you right over. He was taking the puck to the net. He could do it all.
There's a 19-year-old showing you the ability that he has and what his future is all about.
It's better playing on his team than against him, I can tell you that.
Lindros scored 41 goals in his rookie season despite missing almost 20 games with a knee injury. And in 1995, he won the Hart Trophy as league MVP and the Lester Pearson Award. But the passionate power forward had bigger aspirations.
Thank you to the fans of Philadelphia who supported us when we weren't so good. We're getting better, and we're going to do it.
There was lots that I was putting on myself to go and try to achieve. Our team wasn't real deep. With a couple of moves, you could see the makings of a real quality team.
A trade with Montreal would bring John LeClair to Philadelphia, where he teamed with Lindros and Mikael Renberg to create one of the scariest lines in hockey.
Legion of Doom with LeClair and Renberg, you know, they were so tough to play against.
There's a lot of meat on that line, and it was just a battle.
His line was miserable to play against. They were making it completely difficult on me as a defenseman.
Once we got things rolling, it just seemed to click.
He scores! And the Legion of Doom is weaving their magic tonight.
Lindros and the Legion of Doom helped the Flyers capture an Eastern Conference championship in 1997. They faced Detroit in the Cup final, but came up short. In 8 years with the Flyers, Eric Lindros scored at least 30 goals 6 times and became the 5th fastest player to 500 points. But injuries, including concussions, began to take their toll. Lindros finished his career with the Rangers, Leafs, and Stars, and retired in 2007.
For 5 years, no one dominated the game like Lindros. But unfortunately, because of injury and the way he played the game, his career was cut short.
He sustained probably more major hits than any other player in history and still battled through them, went on to have a well-deserved Hall of Fame career.
It's humbling to stand here today to accept a place in the Hockey Hall of Fame. Since the time I started playing pro hockey until today, my life is as good as it's ever been.
When you're having fun, you're playing well. And I certainly had a lot of great times and a lot of smiles.